Oliver Lee Jackson is an incredibly important artist in the post-war American art scene. He really pushes the limits of the medium of paint, of drawing, of printmaking, and he works across many mediums.
It's a retrospective selection of 12 paintings, drawings, and prints by Oliver Lee Jackson, showing a range of works over more than 50 years. And you get a kind of great sense of Oliver's progression. The earlier work is more linear. You really get a sense of the importance of drawing. And in the later work, you start to see the importance of impasto, sort of gestural, oil painting. Oliver's work demands close looking. And the more you look, the more you see. Oliver is from St. Louis. He was born here in 1935. In the late 1960s, he was associated with a group called the Black Artists Group in St. Louis. Really important group of artists, musicians, poets, writers who were trying to promote African-American art and culture in St. Louis. Oliver is an artist who, in terms of 20th century black artists, is an artist who hasn't been sufficiently appreciated.
So in one gallery, we're showcasing his paintings from the early 1970s to the present. And in another gallery, we have his works on paper, which include printmaking, drawing, and watercolor. He doesn't see any one medium or one material as being higher or more important than another. He thinks that all of his work starts from a gesture or a feeling. And he's really interested in creating what he calls a kind of intimacy between the viewer and the artwork.
We're showing strong selection of his work from the early Sharpeville series, which deals with the Sharpeville massacre in South Africa in 1960 and his very intense personal response to that. So what you actually see here is a group of boys who are actually running from bullets. But in Oliver's iteration here, they're kind of abstracted. They're occupying this indeterminate space outside of time, and he's interested in that idea.
After he traveled around the continent of Africa, he was really influenced in the way that African artists utilized a variety of materials, from wood carving to nails, and he started employing collage materials in his own canvases. But he's also really interested in the history of European printmaking. He was very classically trained in intaglio printing and woodblock carving, but also abstract expressionism and European expressionism, from Kandinsky to Pollock to, you know, even contemporary modes of painting. He comes at it from this kind of overarching idea of art, and that includes music and that includes poetry. He's really interested in art in its kind of holistic way.
He's always loved music, associated closely with Julius Hemphill, really important jazz musician. There's a nice comparison you can make between Oliver's practice and the importance that he gives to spontaneity and jazz music.
He thinks of his artwork as this deep-looking, very experiential object, and he does that through all of these different mediums, and he takes each medium as its starting point. So for drawing, it's about the line, it's about the form, it's about this gesture, and you see figures or kind of empty space kind of play against each other, this kind of figure-ground relationship. Although for Oliver, he also believes that all of these binaries we like to assign things for art history are false. So for him, figures are made of paint, or made from a drawn line, or made from an etched line, and therefore they are not figures, they are forms, they are art. They come from the same materials that abstract spaces come from. And so he likes to think of these things as these expanding spaces that interact. So you'll see things appear in the canvases and the drawings, and that's what the close looking is about. It's about really looking and seeing where you think you see a little figure or a crouching person or a flying form, and really thinking about it. There's no wrong or right way to look at an Oliver Jackson picture.